All right, in my last video, I have this Kona Mahuna here, and I did a 1,000 watt Bafang mid-drive conversion installation here. So this is actually not the 1,000 watt I installed in the last video. I took the 1,000 watt off and I put it on this Rocky Mountain Soul here. So here's the 1,000 watt Bafang mid-drive BBS HD. After taking the 1,000 watt off, I put the 750 watt on this bike. So here we have a 750 watt BBS O2. And I said once I get both these kits installed, I was going to do a update video on comparing the two. So if you're thinking about doing one of these conversion kits, you might be thinking, is it worth upgrading to the 1000 watt over the 750? Is it worth spending the extra couple $100? I know if you live in Canada, you are limited to street legal 500 watts. In the US, it's 750. So technically in the US, this would be street legal. If you go up to the 1000, it technically would not be street legal. So the difference between the two, I would say there really isn't much of a difference. The 1000 watt has a little bit more torque, maybe 10 to 20% more torque. Top speed is around the same. Both motors feel very, very similar. It's almost impossible to really tell the difference. Now, I am running different motors and different bikes, but keep in mind, I did have both motors on this bike and I tried them out back to back, and there's a very little difference. Again, the 1000 watt is a little bit more power, but it's really not that noticeable. So would it be worth upgrading to the 1000 watt over the 750? Probably not. I would probably stick with the 750 personally, unless you really want to have that little bit of extra power. So I like the 750 so much, I actually ordered a second 750 to be putting on this bike here, the Rocky Mountain Soul. And I also have a 40 amp hour Samsung battery coming. So this is going to be a super long range bike conversion here. I can't wait to build it. I'm just waiting for the parts to come in. If you have any questions, if you're thinking about doing one of these builds, you can put a comment below. I'll be happy to answer any questions you have. Also too, I just finished building these bikes. If you have any suggestions, throw a suggestion out there. Now the builds did go pretty good. I did actually have a kit on this bike here just to try it out to make sure it works, and it does. This one was a good bike to convert. So I got a Rocky Mountain Soul here. Got a Rocky Mountain Growler. This is a 2019 Growler. It's got a 2.8 fat tire. So this is actually a really fun bike to ride. So I absolutely love this conversion here. This is probably my favorite one that I've done. My favorite e-bike I've ridden yet. I do love having the big motor here. Even though it's not much more powerful than the 750. I definitely have been enjoying riding this bike here. So I love the 2.8 inch fat tires. So these aren't super fat. They're not your 4-inch fat tires. But they're a little bit bigger than, you know, for instance, these 2.2s. And I definitely like the feel. I like the look. This is a higher end mountain bike, so it does have a drop seat, which is nice. You can hit a throttle, or you got a switch here you hit, and basically the seat will adjust as you're riding. I do like that this one has a really big cassette, which does make the e-bike conversion nice. Now when you do these conversions, you lose your front derailleur. So the nice thing is with having a big cassette, it gives you more gear options. See, this is a much smaller cassette. So that might be something to take into account when you're doing one of these conversions. Although it's not really needed. I mean, this is perfectly fine. You know, with the with these motors, they're super powerful. And, you know, even 3 or 4 of the gears is more than enough. But it is nice having the option here. So any comments, questions, post below. When I get my 750 watt in, my other one, and the 40 amp hour battery, I'll do a video on that. So yeah, I'm going to be doing some more videos here on these kits. I love them. Couldn't be happier with them. Very, very happy. If you're thinking about doing one of these, I highly recommend it. They're really not that hard to install.